चैप्टर वन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम नैमिषारण्य। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ही वॉज वॉकिंग फास्ट टुवर्ड्स द सदर्न स्लोप्स ऑफ द हिमवन। ही वॉज अलोन। ही स्कैन्ड द डिस्टेंस एंड डिसर्न्ड द थिन स्पाइरल ऑफ स्मोक स्नेकिंग इट्स वे टू द स्काइज। द स्पॉट वॉज नॉट फार अवे। हिज फुटस्टेप्स वेर नाउ फास्टर एंड सून ही अराइव्ड एट अ क्लस्टर ऑफ थैच्ड रूफ्स। He had arrived at Naimisharanya. When they saw him, a number of rishis stood up and welcomed him gladly. They offered Argya and Padya. Making sure that he was feeling fresh after his long trek, they spoke to him in humble tones. Shaunaka, the leader of the group, stood with folded palms and said, "Our hermitage is honored by the visit of the great Ugrashrava, the son of Roma Harshana. Vyasa was your father's guru, and from that great seer, Vyasa, your father has learnt all the Puranas. As for you, you are famed as the Suta Pauranika, and we are all eager to sit at your feet and listen to the many stories which you know so well. Please recount all of them to us." Suta smiled at them and said, "I heard that you were set on performing the Brahma Satra, a yajna which should last for 1,000 years. Dwapara, the third quarter of the time has passed and Kali has set in. With the advent of Kali, the earth has become the home of adharma, of untruth, of injustice and all the many sins which are the attendants of Kali. This holy spot, I know, cannot be touched by Kali, and I came here. Tell me what I can do for you and I will do my best to please you." "It is the state of the earth ridden with Kali that has made us dread the future," said Shaunaka. "Man is no longer assured of his 100 years of life. Diseases rob him of his youth and his death is premature. His physical well-being is threatened by many ills. His mind is clouded by Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada and Matsarya, the 6 arch enemies of man. These in their turn are attended by smaller evils. Man's intellect is clouded by ignorance. If he has to emerge out of this illusion called Maya, if he has to save his soul from this sinful life on earth, he will have to study the Dharma Shastras, the Puranas, the Vedas. But the man of today has neither the time nor the inclination to study what is good for him. Please, therefore, let us know about a single Kausaya, a single great work, a single poem studying which man can become pure and good and be freed from the bondage of karma." Krishna, the incarnation of Lord Narayana, was on the earth during Dwapara. He left us and went away, and with him went dharma, righteousness. People are groping in the darkness called ignorance. It is up to you, my lord, to tell us where dharma has found refuge after the disappearance of Krishna." Ugrashrava was pleased with their question. He smiled at them and said, "I will tell you where righteousness has found refuge after Krishna left the earth. The sun has risen, the sun which will dispel the inner darkness in the mind of man during this sinful Kali Yuga. That sun is the great Bhagavata Purana composed by the seer Vedavyasa. The Bhagavata tells you the story of the Lord and the many avatars he took to establish dharma on the earth. He is the infinite, the incomprehensible, not bound by anything, not by the chain of cause and effect, which makes the ordinary man live through janma after janma in an endless cycle. He is beyond all this, but man is not good enough or great enough to realize him. He can see only through human eyes, pursue only through the senses and grasp things only through the human intellect. We approach him with the eyes of man born of women. We ascribe to him qualities which we have and try to gauge him by our standards. Knowing all this, the Lord, in his infinite kindness, has in the past assumed forms of living beings so that we could see him. Through these descents into the world of men, the Lord has helped man again and again. He has established dharma whenever there was threat of its being eclipsed. contemplating on the absolute will not be possible for man today, ridden as he is by besetting sins. But even the worst sinner can be saved if he listens to the stories of the Lord, his many avatars. The Bhagavata is just that. The path to the Lord is devotion, the Bhakti Marga. It is Bhakti which we see as the golden thread running through all the avatars. The Bhagavata is a string of beads which, like a Japamala, helps you to realize the Lord and reach him. Vyasa composed this Puranas as his last contribution for the good of the world. I will tell you how it came about. Shri Krishna Arpanamastu. Chapter 2 of Srimad Bhagavata. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. The coming of Narada. The river Saraswati was flowing placidly. On the banks of the river was the ashramas of Vyasa. It was evening time and he was sitting on the sands, gazing at the ripples in the river with unseeing eyes. His eyes were sad and his face troubled. Some deep pain was mirrored in his thoughtful eyes, and so he sat for a long time. The silence around him was broken by the twanging of the strings of the veena. Sweet notes fell on his ears. With the music of the veena was heard a voice singing the praise of Narayana. Vyasa looked up with an eager face and found the young sage, Narada, coming towards him. Vyasa got up in a flurry, welcomed the divine Rishi and made him take a seat of honor. He then sat at his feet, at the feet of young Rishi, who was a son of Brahma. Narada smiled at Vyasa and said, I hope all is well with you. I hope that sickness and disease do not bother you. I am confident that your mind, clear like a pond, is without agitations. You ought to be happy since you have composed the great poem, the Mahabharata, which is a storehouse of knowledge, of all the rules of conduct. It is indeed a great achievement and the world of men will benefit by your work. As for you, learned as you are in the Brahma Vidya, you must be without any sorrow. He paused for a while and Vyasa sat silent without uttering a word. Narada spoke again. He said, It seems to me as though you are not looking happy. You seem to me like one who has not achieved what he wanted to. You have done so much and yet to you, I think it seems to be inadequate. What is worrying you? What makes you unhappy? What you say is perfectly true, said Vyasa. And you are the only person who can clear my doubts. You are wise. You are the son of Brahma. You are ever lost in praising the glories of Lord Narayana. And it seems to me there is nothing which is beyond your intellect. You are like the sun which sees all the three worlds. With the power of your yoga, you can, like the air, enter into human beings and know what is hidden in their minds. You must be knowing the reason why I am despondent. Long ago, I was once absorbed in meditation. In my mind's eye, I saw the future of the world. I saw the deterioration of dharma. I saw the nature of man undergoing a change for the worse. I saw that advent of Kali, of the sinfulness pervading the earth. I saw the gradual withdrawal of the glory that had been her heritage all these years. And I was filled with infinite pity for the generations of men that are to be born in the Kali Yuga. I therefore resolved to help them in their distress. I edited the Vedas. I divided it into four parts and these four were taught to my disciples. Paila learnt the Riks and Jaimini. The Sama, Vaishampayana, was the only one who could master the Yajurveda. Sumantu became proficient in Atharva Veda. To Roma Harshana, I taught the 17 Puranas and the Itihasas. These disciples of mine have divided the Vedas further and they have taught them to their disciples and they in their turn to theirs. I found that I had not done enough. I realized that those who cannot study the Vedas, those who are not allowed to do so should also be saved. And so I composed the poem by name Mahabharata, wherein all the lessons of the Vedas are taught in the course of the narration of the story. I had hoped that humanity will benefit by all this. And yet, my friend, I feel that my work does not grant me satisfaction. Or rather, I have not the peace, the state of tranquility that should be mine by right if I have done the right thing. Tell me what I have left undone. What is it that will grant me peace? Tell me, please. I am sorely distressed by this unrest inside me. With a slight smile lighting up his young face, Narada said, I know the reason. You have not done enough. Not done enough? Echoed Vyasa with dismay. I have tried to do all that I possibly could. I have set down all that I thought was essential for the well-being of man and for his walking in the path of Dharma. What else is left? Tell me. I still maintain that you have not done enough, continued Narada. There is still something you have to achieve before you attain peace. You have done a great service to humanity by composing the Mahabharata. There is no doubt about it, but there is one drawback in that great work. Vyasa was listening to him as a student would, to the words of his guru. A drawback in the Mahabharata? He was eager to know what it was. He did not speak a word, but his eyes were questioning as if to say, please tell me, go on and tell me what the drawback is and how I can rectify it. I am eager and impatient to know. Narada said, you were interested in the welfare of the world, and by relating the story of the Pandavas, you have taught the lesson that righteousness will conquer in the end. And where Krishna is, there is found Dharma. This is the lesson, and there is no doubt that people will learn it. But you have, throughout the epic, laid stress on the duties of the man, on his Dharma, on his performing them selflessly. The Bhagavad Gita and all the other discourses on Dharma lay stress on Karma Yoga, as you call it. But my friend, you have not sung the praises of the Lord as much as you ought to have. Know you not that the easiest path to the Lord is the path of bhakti? All the other yogas are harder paths which lead to the feet of the Lord. The praises of Narayana, even if they are couched in wrong words, even if they are sung all out of tune, will assure man of the grace of the Lord. Like a piece of arni, which when churned will give forth smoke first and later fire, which will consume the wood itself, even so, the mind of man, when churned by the constant devotion to the Lord, will make all the evil in him come out on to the surface. The true sattvic nature of man will then blaze forth in like fire, will consume the bondage of karma and grant him salvation forever and ever. The Mahabharata was to you a play. Your attitude was purely objective. You entered into every one of the characters. You were therefore thinking good thoughts as well as evil ones while in the process of portraying them. Incidentally, the Lord was praised. There was no single-mindedness about your devotion to him. You must try to make up for this omission. Sing the praises of Narayana. Relate to the world his Vishwarupa, his Virata Rupa, his Vibhutis, his Avataras, and this, I assure you, will grant you the peace you are seeking. Unveil to the world the secret behind the avatars. Tell them why the Lord, who is beyond the opposites, who has his abode in Ananta, who is the Purusha, the life giver to this entire universe, why he should take a form and a name and a birth and become like one of us, why he should appear to be infused with one or the other of the three gunas and act as though he were a human being with human emotions. Praise every avatar of the Lord. Let nothing come from your lips except words of praise describing the glory of Narayana, and you will find peace. Drive home to the world of men this lesson. Even if a man fails in his duties, duties which are ascribed to him by the Vedas and by the elders, even if he is a sinner who has transgressed all rules of conduct, still, if in his heart there is a spring of love, of devotion to the Lord, that will wash his sins white and he will be dear to him. Remember, my friend, that you are yourself an avatara of Narayana. You have been born into this world for the benefit of mankind, and yet you allow emotions to delude you. Remember who you are. Wake up from this sleep which makes you forget your real nature. Relate to everyone the many avataras of Narayana and the purpose behind each of them. Sing the praises of Narayana again, again, and yet again. You will then have reached the goal for which you have been striving. Peace. Om Shanti. 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 Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.